medium man, physical medium man, physical medium man. What'd you buy? Was it something good?
What's up, guys? Physical Medium Man back here again for another Physical Medium Man Monday video. I have another vlog video from our trip to West Virginia and Charleston and Blacksburg, Virginia. So before I get started, make sure to like, subscribe, comment, leave feedback, do a lot of good stuff down below. I'll leave the links to my website, my Instagram page, my Physical Medium Man store Instagram page, my Facebook page for the Physical Medium Man / Physical Medium Man store, my Facebook page for non-media related items, the Hodgepodge Garage, my email, my eBay, my Twitter, and my Letterboxd account. So yeah, a few weeks ago at least, we went to first to Charleston, West Virginia, stayed a night there and were there during the day and had a very good time there. And then from there, we headed on to Blacksburg, Virginia, where we were going to the Notre Dame Virginia Tech game, which ended up being a lot of fun. We stayed at the Dirty Dancing Lodge from the film. So here comes some clips and yeah, so hope you guys enjoyed this. This is the third or fourth vlog video I've done, and I've really enjoyed doing them, so hope you enjoyed this.
Almost heaven, West Virginia, West Virginia, West Virginia, West Virginia.
Our first planned stop of our vacation was Dim Two Brothers and a Grill as soon as we got into Charleston, West Virginia. This is proof that things don't always go as planned while on vacation. They were closed for renovations, and I was really bummed because I was really looking forward to checking this place out. This was probably the place I was most excited for food-wise of our whole trip. It had great reviews, and the pictures made the food look really good. It also had a neat story with the person that owns it, Adrian Bay Wright, being a former NFL football player for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and coming back to the town he went to high school in, and giving back with this great, from what I hear, barbecue. Hopefully, whenever we get to Charleston again, if that ever happens, we'll be able to check it out. But I still wanted to include it on this video because it looks awfully good. So if you're ever in the area, check it out and let me know how it is. Our backup plan led us to Husson's Pizza, with multiple locations in the area, but based out of Charleston. Pizza ended up being very good there. I don't know if I get the breadsticks again, but the pizza was really good. Next, we headed to the West Virginia State Museum, right next to the state capitol. It was a really impressive museum. It was free. I definitely recommend going to this too if you're able to. I didn't know too much about the history of West Virginia, so it was really interesting. To end our day, we stopped by this market and got some West Virginia related items. Then we stumbled upon this really impressive car show. Have you ever noticed that it always seems like there's one car that's there that definitely shouldn't be there? Can you spot that car? After the car show, we went to Recovery Sports Grill, where the atmosphere was better than the food, but it's a good place to watch a game and eat. The next day, I had booked a tour of the state capital of West Virginia. This was also free, and I highly recommend it. It's also right next to the museum. The current capital was built from 1924 to 1932. Prior to that, there were capitol buildings in both Wheeling and Charleston. Since 1885, the capitol has remained in Charleston. The current building is really a sight to see. No expense was spared. It cost a little less than $10 million to build at the time of construction. It's now insured for around $500 million and has three chandeliers inside of it that are worth $1 million each. It would cost over $1 billion to reconstruct the building. The building encompasses more than 14 acres of floor space. Two-thirds of the interior consists of marble. The walls are made of Imperial Danby, and the floors are a combination of white Vermont marble and dark Italian travertine. It is really a sight to see, and you can definitely tell that no expense was spared. I've been in at least one other state capitol building, and this one was a lot more impressive than that one, so definitely check it out if you're able to. After our tour, we left Charleston, West Virginia, and made our way towards Blacksburg, Virginia. Once we got to Blacksburg, we had lunch at McAdoo's. It had a really neat atmosphere inside, and the food was pretty good. I would go back. Once we finished lunch, we headed towards Mountain Lake Lodge and the filming location for Dirty Dancing, where we'll be staying the next two nights. She's like the wind through my tree. She rides the night next to me. She leads me through moonlight, only to burn me with the sun. She's taking my heart.
She doesn't know what she's done. Feel the breath in my face, her body close to me. Can't look in her eyes, she's out of my league. Just a fool to believe I have anything she needs. She's like the wind. And all I see is a young old man with only a dream. Am I just fooling myself that she'll stop the pain? Living without her, I go insane.
I've been to quite a few filming locations, but this one probably takes the cake. Being so close to multiple locations that served a giant purpose in the film and were almost a character within themselves. You got the lodge, you got Baby's cabin, and you got the gazebo, all in really close walking distance. Plus, you get to stay here, which is another really neat aspect of coming to the Mountain Lake Lodge, which was the filming location for Dirty Dancing.
Now I had the time of my life. No, I never felt like this before. Yes, I swear it's a truth, and I owe it all to you.
Cause I
I never felt
next morning we took in the Dirty Dancing filming location some more, and then headed down the mountain into Blacksburg for the main event of our trip, Notre Dame versus Virginia Tech. After getting parked on the Virginia Tech campus, we went to the Cellar restaurant, which was really neat and probably the best place that we ate during our trip. It was recommended by one of Jordan's former classmates, and it did not disappoint. It was so good I forgot to take a video of the pizza, but I scored it a 9.2, and if we ever get back there, I'll definitely get it. It was also connected to a liquor store on the other side, and we got some Virginia beer to bring home with us. Next up, we headed towards campus more and saw some of the buildings in the Hokie Stone. And then we were off for the game. Thank you.
time for kickoff. We got back to the lodge very late. The next morning, we headed back towards Indiana. On our way to West Virginia and Virginia, we passed by the Bob Evans farm. That weekend that we were going to be heading back, they had the Bob Evans 50th anniversary festival going on. This wasn't on our radar. We didn't know it was going on, but when we passed by, we decided if we had time and felt up to it that we would go there on the way back to Indiana. So we decided to stop.
Rising tide. So something in the way the world has changed, broken apart and rearranged. And the river's rising, rain keeps pouring down. And the river's rising, oh, take me to higher ground. Not too little, much too late, born in disaster and tempting fate. Against all natural laws, put in effect before the cause. And the river's rising, rain keeps pouring down. Down, down, down. River's rising, oh, take me to higher ground.
Virginia and Virginia, and it was really beautiful there. We had great food, saw some really neat filming locations, had a lot of fun, and brought back a Notre Dame victory.
Physical media man, physical media man, physical media man, yeah!